With the conclusion I made that God Almighty is immortal, but Jesus was mortal.
I told you the reason why.
You kept saying nature.
Jesus, God, the Son of God, became a human.
Only human?
I told you. No, God in humanity.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Which is the second person of Trinity. The humanity is not something which sticks by itself. It is linked to the second person of the Trinity. Similarly, the divinity is the nature of His God, which doesn't stick by itself. It is linked to the second person of the Trinity.
That's true.
You already admitted second person of Trinity died.
Am I right? Yes.
So that means he's mortal.
No, in humanity, because of humanity.
What do you mean humanity? Humanity doesn't mean Jesus is a separate person.
No, he's not a separate person. You are not being honest.
I am being sincere. And I'm being consistent in my answer that the nature is always attached to the person. Did the person die?
This is going in.
Yes, he died.
No, I answered it.
When a person dies, that means he is mortal.
Please,
you have to admit this.
Please.
Now, if you're not sincere, there's no point carrying on this. My friend.
No, I'm going to ask you this question.
You are stuck in the circle and you need to come out.
You are stuck in the circle. You need to come out.
Actually, you believe. So you believe God dies?
I am asking.
You actually believe God dies?
No, I'm not going to ask you. Answer you now.
Now, if you're not being sincere, remember what I said earlier? That if you're not being sincere, I want to have a sincere.
No.
I want to have a discussion which is friendly. I want to have a discussion which actually uses...
No, brother, I am asking you this question.
You are able to give me evidence.
He's your prophet. Why are you running away?
He's your prophet.
He's the best example to mankind.
He's the best example to us.
Mankind?
Yes.
He is. Do you accept everything written in Bukhari and Sahih Muslim?
If they are Sahih, yes.
I have to qualify
my answers the way I want.
Do you believe that?
What is the point you're making?
Do you believe that Muhammad married a 6-year-old child?
Yes.
Do you believe that?
Yes.
You agree that?
Yes.
Do you believe that a 50 or 51 year old man marrying a 6-year-old child is a good, best example to mankind?
By today's standard, no.
In any standard?
No. At that time, Mary got pregnant at 12 years old.
No.
Is your God a good standard?
No.
Who made her pregnant?
No.
Your God. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. He says God means all three. No, I'm not. It's the same. Because if you're calling Muhammad someone who's a child abuser, then your God is a child abuser.
I didn't say that.
What are you claiming? What is it you're claiming?
This is my question.
What?
He's a 51-year-old man marrying a 6-year-old girl, a child. The best example to mankind.
It's not the best example. No, I wouldn't say.
Okay, then you would say.
Don't put words in my mouth. No. There's difference between.
Okay, wait. The best example.
So can you tell me? Bro. Listen. Do you believe Mary got pregnant at the age of 12?
No. Let's.
No. Why not?
I will come to that.
You will?
I will come to
that. Is that the best example?
Where does it say Mary was 12 years old?
Okay, show me in the Quran where he says that.
Whoa, you already agreed with me that you will...
You want evidence from the script?
No.
From your own sources? From the Christian sources?
No, from my Bible.
Okay, show me from the Quran then. Show me from the Quran.
No. Show me from the Quran that you have to pray 5 times.
In many places it says.
Show me. Yes.
How to pray it doesn't say.
No.
But to pray five times a day, yes.
Show
the different timings when it comes.
You are recording.
Wait.
Let him show that.
But why are you changing the topic now? Why are you changing the topic?
Because you said, listen.
You said Muhammad wasn't a good example because he married a minor.
No, I am asking you.
But I'm asking you. Mary was 12 years old according to the Catholic Encyclopedia. 12 years old. I'm asking you, how old was your God when he made her pregnant?
I do not follow an encyclopedia.
But you follow the Bible.
Can you show me?
According to the Bible, did God sanction the killing of infants?
You are changing them.
No, I'm not. Because you're telling me, is your God?
Can you show
because
me?
You cannot stand by the
can
same
you,
standards.
No. Can you show me? What? Everything about my faith
is
in the Bible.
Yes, I can.
Okay? Everything
but,
about
But do you think that's a good
faith?
Example?
No.
Is that a good example?
Which one?
Killing infants.
For God, he can.
Really?
Yeah, what is the problem?
Okay.
So if he gave life, so you.
So why are you having a problem?
No. Do you think that it is a problem for Allah to kill infants and everyone in Sodom and Gomorrah?
Can I respond to that? Okay, first and foremost, when I say the Amalekites, which Shamsi gave you the example, which is 1 Samuel 15, yes, here God is telling you, sorry, God himself is not raining down some punishment on them in terms of brimstones and fire or whatever it is, like it happened in Sodom and Gomorrah. This was God himself exacting his punishment on them. However, what we see different in Numbers 23:19, where your God told Moses to go and kill everyone except the ones who were virgins.
Okay.
Yes? You know how many killed? 31,000 of them. 31,000 he saved.
So you
were virgin. Wait, I'm coming to that. No. So the difference between the two is this. In Sodom and Gomorrah, it was God himself exacting the punishment.
Okay.
However, what happened during the time of the Amalekites and the Midianites? Okay. Who took the revenge? Okay. Who?
No, you just
tell me. Okay, I'll tell you. Let's see if you know this.
No.
It wasn't God actually. It was God sanctioning that command for the Jewish people to do it. Yes? The Jews were instructed to go kill every male, every female, every child, every infant. And guess what? In Numbers 23:19.
Brother, you are preaching.
This is the same point.
No, it's the same point. You are not being honest.
Jesus is the God of the
Testament. Share with the point. Okay,
the point is this.
If
Jesus was your best example, he wouldn't tell you to go kill infants. Would he? Because according to Jesus is the God of the Old Testament. Of course, you're running away now. Run away!
I have answer for
you. You will. The point is this. Answer. No, you
but
will not.
You are just talking to him.
Okay, let me finish.
Let's see if we can manage. I understood.
No, you
I
didn't.
Understood.
No, you did not.
You are going to us. No, this is okay, what I understood from you. If I am wrong, let me know.
Yeah,
your point was, in Sodom and Gomorrah, it was God directly killing the children.
Yes.
But in the case of Amalekites, it was God used the people to kill the
God
children.
Instructed the people.
Or instructed the people
yes,
to
sanction
kill
them.
Whether God instructed the people to kill or whether used a natural force to kill the people, killing is killing. It doesn't matter what source God uses.
Killing
is killing.
Yes. Why?
Killing is killing.
Do you know why they were
so
killed?
So your Allah killed infants.
Yeah.
In Sodom and Gomorrah, and you are okay with that. And when God kills in the Old Testament who were sinners, that is sinners, you are not okay with it. So basically,
you haven't understood. I
understood
no,
it.
No, you did not.
My point was this.
The judgment of God is just. The judgment of human beings who take the sword in the hand to kill, they can make up any story. You see, when the Jews were weak, yes, they did not kill the Amalekites. But when they became strong after 400 years, this Amalekites.
Are you talking about Amalekites?
I'm talking about Amalekites, yes. No, I'm talking about Amalekites.
After 400 years,
how is it possible for these people to kill them? Because after 400 years, these Jews became strong. And only then they told the people, look, God is telling us to go and seek revenge. The word revenge is mentioned there.
Okay.
They were killed because of what happened to them in the past.
Okay.
400 years ago. Okay. So these infants who were killed, they were not the ones who were doing anything wrong.
Okay.
Their fathers were not doing anything wrong. Their mothers were not doing anything wrong. It happened 400 years ago. So this was revenge. Not for their fault.
I understood your point.
No, you didn't.
This is a problem.
I don't think you did.
So there is a reason. I can give you that reason. But this is my question.
What was the reason for the killing?
You are against the killing, right?
No, I said against killing. Not just killing
Surah
by itself.
9:29 says, fight those who does not believe in Allah.
And?
Yeah.
Have you read what 86 is?
86?
No. Read it in context then.
No. What is the context? Let's read it in it. Take your Quran.
Why should I take my Quran when every time I ask you to open your Bible, you say I don't have the Bible? Yes?
No, fine.
Every time I ask this guy, where's the Bible?
No.
I don't have it.
No.
So they came preaching with this giant board over here.
No. What's the problem?
And they didn't bring the Bibles with them.
Yeah, that's fine. We don't have to. Because I did not come to argue with you.
No, you didn't.
I came to preach.
Yeah.
Why?
Then you should be able to stand by your own.
You are coming with your cameraman.
Just because you came first,
this is your job. This is not my job. I am standing here to tell people about Jesus Christ. If they have an honest question, I will answer. This is like you don't have to me.
This is what happens in
two cameras.
This is what happens in Speaker's Corner. I'm surprised you're surprised.
No, but
maybe you should have done some research before you came here.
You agreed with me
what?
That 51-year-old Muhammad marrying a 6-year-old child is not the best example to mankind. He agreed with you.
Can I respond to that?
So that means
can I respond to that?
You are disagreeing with Allah.
No, I'm not. Can I respond to that? First and foremost, marrying a minor was quite common in the time of Prophet Muhammad and even before him. So if you look at the Bible, there are several examples where people had married younger even. In fact, if you read the entire Bible, there's not a single verse which gives you the age of consent. The age of consent which you talk about, 18 years old, do you know what is the age of consent in Japan? One of the first world countries? Is 13.
We are not talking
if you go
about
by
that.
The standard, no,
we
I'm going by that. I'm going by that.
No.
Because what standard are you basing it on? The Bible? No, the Bible doesn't have such a standard.
We are talking about he's a 51-year-old man marrying a 6-year-old child, the best example. I am not
based
talking
on whom?
About this.
Based on whom?
I am asking
no, based
you.
On whom?
Based on whose standard? Yeah, my standard. It is.
What is your standard? Example. Is your standard based on the Bible?
I don't know how many of you think that marrying a 6-year-old child, marrying a 50-year-old man or 51-year-old man marrying a 6-year-old child is the best example to humankind. How many of you think that?
None of them. Can I respond to that?
No.
By the way, you know, Mary was 12 years old, and Joseph married her at the age of 12.
Where?
You know how he was 90 years old. Joseph was 90 years old. Shall I show you where?
Yeah, show
okay.
me. Show me.
First and foremost.
In the Bible.
Oh, in the Bible. Okay, you show me the Quran then.
Yeah?
Huh?
The Quran says Muhammad is the best example.
He is. But show me the marriage.
You agree?
Show me the marriage in the Quran. You see, he doesn't have it in the Quran. Just like you expect me to show him from the Bible, I'm asking him to show me from the Quran. Do you see the double standard? Joseph was 90 years old when he married a 12-year-old Mary who was already pregnant by his God. And you know what? The worst thing is, if Jesus is God, then he made his own mother pregnant. Now you tell me, if anyone is talking about rationality, can you make your own mother pregnant?
Because of the absurdity of that Bible, the absurdity of your God, then you cannot.
Yes, run away with your cameras.
Okay,
so now he's talking to his camera. I'm going to talk to our cameras. Bring it here, who is this? Come here, come here.
Look, daddy, it's finished now.
Okay, so Joseph was 90 years old when he married a 12-year-old Mary. Now, if you're having a problem with a 6-year-old marry a 50-year-old, then you should also have a problem with that. But the reason he had to bring up the young marriage of Aisha, it is anachronistic. Means it is not something that you judge by today's standard, what was happening 1400 years ago. The Jews, the Christians, even the pagans, even the Muslims, this was a different time, a different standard. You do not judge it by the 21st standard. However, if you believe that Jesus had a mother called Mary, and if you believe that Mary had a God who was a triune God, then Jesus is also her God. In other words, the Holy Spirit is also her God. In other words, the Father is also her God. Did the Holy Spirit make Mary pregnant? According to them, yes. He basically shadowed her and he made her pregnant. I'm not saying this is through sexual intercourse. However he made her pregnant, he made her pregnant. Now if anybody makes someone pregnant, then automatically the child that is born is the father. He is the father of that child. However, whether it is through IVF or whatever measurement you want to take, if someone makes somebody a woman pregnant and that woman has a child, then automatically becomes a father. Why do they not call the Holy Spirit the Father? Why? Why this discrepancy we see this in the Bible? They have a problem with the young marriage of Aisha, but when we question them about the young marriage of Mary, oh, they don't want to know. They don't want to know that a 90-year-old married, 90-year-old Joseph married a 12-year-old child. Today's standard, a 12-year-old is a child. Yes, in some countries like Japan, they might have an age of consent 13. In some countries like Germany and Italy, they have an age of consent 14. In some parts of America, they don't even have age of consent in some of their states. And they have child marriages there. They have child marriages in India. One of the most moral person people usually give a reference to is Gandhi from India. Guess at what age he got married? At the age of 13. And his wife was even younger, maybe 12 or maybe the same age. That was child marriage accepted then, because that was a different time. We do not judge them by that time. However, are the Muslims required to marry a young woman? or a child, if you want to call it that. No, they are not. This is not something we are encouraged to do. Yes, you won't find among the companions many people marrying young girls. But this was something at that time which was practiced. And not only that, it is not only about sex, which most of these people are thinking about, that how can you have sex with a child? If Muhammad was indeed someone who was abusing children, then he would have consummated the marriage at the age of 6. Why did he wait until later, 3 years or more? Why did he wait for that consummation? Because the ruling of getting married and consummation of marriage was determined by the age of puberty at that time. And as soon as puberty set in, Aisha radiallahu anha, yes, then they consummated the marriage. This clearly shows what was in time practice at that time. And nothing that if you went 1400 years ago, you wouldn't find this to be problematic, because everybody at that time accepted it. It was acknowledged, and they had a very short lifespan. They would actually sometimes live only up to their mid-30s or something, and they would die. So they would, even amongst the Jewish tradition, they used to get married at very early age. So even though the Bible doesn't say Mary was 12 years old when she got married, they take into consideration the history of the Jewish people living 2000 years ago. How did they basically conduct marriages and at what age? It was determined at a very young age they used to get married. And that's how they, by the writing of some of the first century scholars, they came to the conclusion that she was either 12 or 13 or maybe slightly older, but it was around that range, which today's standard would find problematic. But anyway, that wasn't my discussion. The discussion that he wanted not to go further, and he did not even understand the two natures of Jesus, the divine and the human. He kept saying the human nature died, as if trying to say that was a different person who died. It was the same second person of Trinity who died. And as soon as he died, then he's a mortal. You cannot say he's immortal. And that was the point I raised with him, which he didn't want to understand, because I can explain it to him, but I cannot understand it for him. And this is the discussion we had, so alhamdulillah, at least we tried to conduct it as sincerely as possible. But as soon as we showed them about examples, like in the case of Sodom and Gomorrah, where God exacts his punishment, yes, that is we acknowledge. But when they say that this is what God told us to do after 400 years in the case of Amalekites, like in 1 Samuel 15, then we don't buy that. Because it shows me that these people are just using the excuse that God told them, that to go and kill these women and children and even infants and even the animals. Yes, because that shows insincerity there, that you are saying that God would actually instruct human beings to go door to door, yes, and to kill them mercilessly, inhumanely, and not only the adults but even the little infants. The infants are normally 2 years old and younger, so even newborn babies were killed mercilessly. You see, Allah says in the Quran that he does not test you beyond your scope. And this is what is against a human nature, to test you beyond your scope, i.e. to tell you specifically to go and knock from door to door and to kill infants and children and everyone in that household. This is something which is unlike what we see from a merciful God. But at the end of the day, if that is what they want to believe, then that's fine. Then why do they point to the Muslim atrocities that take place around the world? Yes, of course we don't agree with them. The people who call themselves the Islamic State and so on, they say they represent Islam. No, they don't. In Islam, we have a code of conduct, even when we went to war. This is what our Prophet Muhammad instructed us, not to kill the women or the children or anybody else who is not fighting you, or the people who are in the churches and the synagogues, the priests and the rabbis, or do not destroy the crops or the animals, the livestock. These instructions were given at times of war during the time of Muhammad and during his time of his companions. Yes, alhamdulillah, we see this when? Today mentioned in the Geneva Convention, obviously not word for word, but many of this is encapsulated in the Geneva Convention. They have rules of engagement during war. But the thing is, if you look at the Old Testament, yes, anyone that they occupied and anyone who did not believe in God, they would mercilessly massacre everyone. And God would tell them, do not spare even one person or soul. They would massacre the animals and the plants even. Because many times they give the reason, oh, because they were sinners. What sin has the animal committed, or the plants that they were destroyed?
You see, this is the inconsistency we see from a God who is merciful and kind and just. Alhamdulillah, in Islam, this is consistent. We see. We do not judge by the standards of that time. And like I said, these are things you got to take into context, the history of that time. If you're going to negate anything from history, from the time of those, from the time the people lived 1400 years ago, 2000 years ago, then you will be in jeopardy throughout, whether you're reading the Quran or the Bible or the Hadith or anything. Alhamdulillah, with that we conclude that we talked about the oneness of God. There are things in the Bible that we don't disagree with, the oneness of God, for example. And I've told them repeatedly that this is something which is the truth in the Bible, and we go by this.
Wassalatu wassalam ala rasulil kareem. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.